Learning Software Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1634, PowerView. Did you see the news this morning? It's all over the news, Office 2013 coming out. That means that very soon your chance to try Excel 2013, the preview, ends. So I know that it goes through at least through midnight January 31st, 2013. You got to try this out, tinyurl.com/XL13preview. It gives you a chance to try it before you can buy it. Now, I've been negligent. Microsoft, a long time ago, offered me some free annual subscriptions. I'm guaranteed to get four if I have the most downloads from my site. Mr. Excel generates more downloads than the others, then I get 18 one-year licenses to give away. All right, so how are we going to give these away? They can't tell me who downloads it. So go to tinyurl.com/XL13preview, download the Office 2013 trial, and then shoot a screenshot. You know, just use print screen or snag it or whatever. Send that to bill at MrExcel.com. You have to send it before midnight, January 31st, 2013. And then what we're going to do is we're going to do a equal rand drawing from all the entries. And I'm going to take those four or 18 one-year subscriptions. That's a $99 value. It's good for five PCs. And we'll award those, let's say, you know, February 1st, 2nd. Let's do it Groundhog's Day, February 2nd. All right. And then, you know, so this is kind of, I realize this is squirrely, right? Am I doing 4 or 18? I really don't know. So if you take the time to go ahead and download this, I will send you Chris Smith's new Excel 2010 Business Basics and Beyond. If you're in the USA, I'll send you a physical copy of the book. Outside of the USA, I'll send you an ebook. And let's say we'll do that for the first 100 people, which conceivably is everybody who tries this. So there we go. Again, download from tinyurl.com/XL13preview, screenshot to bill at MrExcel.com before January 31st, 2013. All right, today's episode is PowerView. I've done a lot about Excel 2013, but I haven't talked about PowerView. Why is that? I was afraid, right? I thought it was really complicated. When you get right down to it, it's incredibly powerful and amazing to use. It's a add-in that comes with Excel 2013, the Pro Plus version. So if you have PowerPivot, you'll get PowerView. And it allows us to create a dashboard. So you see here we have sheets for fact, geography, products, dates, and PowerView. It's just, it's like another sheet in the workbook. And we have the dashboard view over here, the field list over here, and then optionally we have a filter pane that can come and go. And we can have these tiny little tiles. We can click this icon to pop the tile out, pop out, and so here is an XY chart with lots of information going on. Down the left-hand side is the list price of the book. Across the bottom is the page count of the book. The color of the dot tells us what version it's written about, and then the size is revenue in this hypothetical data set. And across the bottom we have a play axis that is based on year. So now watch this. This is so wild. I'm going to click play, and we'll actually get to see this data change over time. So here's 2008. The 2007 books are coming on strong. Let it go. Let it go. There's the first 2010 books showing up, and then again hypothetical data set going out into the future, showing the 2013 books. Isn't that cool? I can take the slider and look at any individual year. And this is just one of the things that PowerView can do. Let me minimize this again, or just pop in. They call pop in, pop out. What a strange word. So I'm going to go to the geography, and let's choose perhaps state, and I'll drag state. This creates a brand new tile here, and initially all of the tiles are going to show up as just a regular old table. That's the way that every new tile shows up in PowerView, but that's okay. Now let's go to the fact table and find revenue. See, and because that was the active tile, I just check mark it, it goes. Beautiful, right? Now, this is a boring old table. I could just scroll through it. Yeah. But let's change it to a map. All right, so these are the things. We can take it from a table, matrix or card view, bar chart, column chart, other chart, or a map. All right, now one really frustrating thing. The table started out small, and so then the map starts out small. But you can always resize, or you can always pop out. All right, so there they took all of my data and put it on a map. If I had chosen city instead of state, let's try that. So we'll take state out, and in my geography table, find city. put that there. All right, see, it takes a little bit of time for it to geocode it, but it finds all the cities. And so big sales in New York, LA. There we go, it's still geocoding. Isn't that cool? Oh, even some places up in Canada are popping out, and that's crazy. Now it's getting some spots in Europe, so it's not just a US centric thing. And again, we can pop in, so we can have all of these different little tiles here on the Power View sheet, very clever. Now, how is this data getting into Excel? Well, Power View, which by the way has a space, Power Space View, uses Power Pivot without a space. So I had here a large data set. This was 400,000 records, 411,000 records of my fact table, and it had product ID, geo ID, and so on. So I have my little lookup tables here, and I put all of this into Power Pivot and created relationships between them. But the most important thing, if you're going to use Power View, is that we need to go and specify certain columns as being, let's call them special. All right, so here under State, on the Advanced tab, there's a data category, and I went through very carefully all of my columns and declared things to be, actually anything that's in this list. All right, so state or province, for city, I called it a city. Anything you have that matches one of these, go ahead and use this. And this is used by Power View to know if it can be mapped or not mapped. There's even, let's see, on products, there we go, yeah, so there was an image path, all right, and unfortunately this is pointing to images on another computer, but you put the image path in there, and then you can actually show product pictures right in your Power View table. Now again, this comes with Excel 2013 Pro Plus. It was out if you had SharePoint, back in the 2010 timeframe, but it now becomes a tool for Excel 2013. And as I said at the beginning, I shied away from showing this on the podcast because it seemed very intimidating. But I've written a chapter in three books now about Power View, and it works. I mean, this is a huge data set, 411,000 records, with three links to other tables and maps and pictures, and the thing has just been so easy to work with. Absolutely amazing. Great little feature. Complaint, I guess, that I have with Power View is when you're in various elements here in Power View, the tabs to the right of Power View, so design and layout, those are Power View tabs and they're not labeled as such. It doesn't say Power View design and Power View layout. I don't know why. These tabs come and go depending on what's selected. And so you just have to look for the Power View tab, and then anything to the right of it up to either Inquire or Power Pivot is actually a Power View tab. A little bit confusing, but beyond that, just an amazing feature. There's more that we can talk about. There's tiles, vertical multiples, horizontal multiples. We'll have to get back to that. But I wanted to show you this. As I was watching the news this morning, they're clicking around showing the SkyDrive, and they're not getting to any of the good features at all. This is the place you can come to get those good features. Wow, this has gone on way too long. I'm going to quit talking. Remember, there's two more days, January 30th, January 31st. You can try Excel 2013 for free. tinyurl.com/Excel13preview. Send me a screenshot that shows you downloaded it, and I'll share the love. All of this, either 4 or 18 one-year subscriptions, that's $99 value. We'll do that using RAND, and then anyone else who tries it, we'll send you a copy of Excel 2010 Business Basics and Beyond by Smitty. If you use the Mr. Excel message board, you'll recognize Smitty. He's one of our most valuable posters there at Mr. Excel. All right. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast, Mr. Excel.